So in percentages, there is a backbone concept which is called as multiplying factor concept. So to understand it better, let us take a very simple question. The turnover of Bajaj Industries increases by 10%. Earlier it was 400 crores. Can you tell the final turnover? So we can easily find out 400 plus 10% of 400, which is 40. And therefore the answer will be 440 crores. Now, what is multiplying factor basically is that we can also do it as 400 into 1.1, which will give us 440. So this 1.1 corresponds to the multiplying factor of 10%. If the percentage increase had been 20%, the multiplying factor would have been 1.2. Had it been 40%, the multiplying factor would have been 1.4. 67%, 1.67. 90%, 1.9. 100%, 2. Multiplying factor is also defined for decreases, percentage decreases. So if there is a 20% decrease, the multiplying factor would be 0.8. If there is 33% decrease, the multiplying factor would be 0.67, and so on. So the beauty concept of multiplying factor is the moment we are given the percentage increase or the percentage decrease, we can immediately find the multiplying factor. And then when we know the multiplying factor, the rule of the percentage is final is always equal to initial into MF, multiplying factor. So this direct concept can be applied to profit and loss question, where the final will become the selling price and the initial will become the cost price. So if we are given the cost price and the profit percent, we can immediately find the selling price by multiplying the cost price into the corresponding multiplying factor, and vice versa. For example, if a shopkeeper is selling a shirt at 1000 rupees and he incurs a loss of 30% in the process, the question says find the cost price. So again, I is equal to F divided by MF by our equation. F here is 1000 and the MF here is 0.7 because it is a case of a loss. So the answer is 1000 divided by 0.7. If we solve, we get the effective cost price of the shirt.